Hello everybody, this is Mr. Fire and welcome to the first video, the first build guide video in 2024 for Titan Quest on this channel. So, here we have a Dragon Spear build. This is a Dragon Hunter, this is why I call it a Dragon Spear, because it is a Dragon Hunter who uses a spear. And this build uses some mastery frequent items, as we can see, and some legendaries as well. I wanted to make this build because I found this weapon, and this weapon is a mastery frequent from Atlantis, which has the crippling suffix, which provides the reduced armor. It also had the tinkerer suffix. The suffix of the tinkerer provides two slots for components. And this is how I have two slots, two components enchanted on this item. And I decided to go with a Dragon Hunter. First, the skills. Hunting mastery. We have maxed out at +4, the Study Prey, the Flash Out add-on. The Takedown has received only 1 point. The same, the add-on, only 1 point. We have maxed out the Valley, maxed out Art of the Hunt. Only 1 point spent on Fight Cover and 1 point on Trail Blazing. And we have maxed out the Spear Dash, which is a very nice melee AoE attack with the Spear. And of course we have maxed out the Wood Lore for more attack speed and defensive ability and the Herbal Remedy, survivability skill. In Rune Mastery, we have maxed out of course Rune Weapon and the Add-on Magical Charge. And only 1 point spent on this one to gain access to the attack damage converted to health. We have spent only a single point on Sacred Rage and a single point on Frightening Power. We have spent only 1 point on Feather. I will max out this one in the future to get more offensive ability. But we have maxed out the Rune Ward Explode and the Rune Ward Burn. This also applies with melee attacks, not only with projectiles. I have spent only 1 point on Rune Ward Absorb to get this effect. The absorption of spell energy and energy leads retaliation per second and shield recovery time. But I have maxed out the Thunder Strike and the add-on Unleash. And last but not least, we have maxed out the Rune of Life, which provides survivability, very good survivability options, movement speed and strength points buff. For the time being, this is the setup of the Masteries. We have one more skill, this one, the Spirit Ward, which comes from an item. We will see the items in a bit. When it comes to attributes, first of all, this character started at level 70 as a legendary hero. I have spent some points on health, no points on energy, no points on intelligence, and the rest of my points went almost equally to strength and dexterity. Dexterity is very important, of course, for spear builds. Here we have movement speed is almost perfect. Defensive ability, offensive ability, very nice stuff. Now we can see this item is ready because we have lost the strength. We have 579, it requires 600. But I need to activate this skill. Now the helmet is back. So for the items, I have created the symbol of the polymath. A legendary hero gets a symbol of the polymath, but that one doesn't have a completion bonus. I have created another one and I got the Army Protection Completion Bonus. Here we have the Brute's Plate, Mastery Frequent item. It has a Transcendent prefix and I wanted to use this one. And I think it looks great with this punch down here. I went with the Amon-Ra's Glory as well. Here we have the Resisted Atlantean Crest of the Tinkerer. I went with this one because I wanted the survivability options from the components and the item itself, and then I wanted to put the Essence of Chaos, which provides flat elemental damage, elemental resistances and attack speed. You know, you get the Essence of Chaos from the endgame dungeons. So here we have it. This item is very nice. Here we have the Armbands of Greater Will. This item is one of the endgame dungeon set items, and it provides the stats that we can see, Immortal Hero set. And I also have the Amulet of Thoth, which is one more part of that set, Immortal Hero. So these two items now provide +4 to all skills. Here we have the Dark Depths. This is a very nice item, it has some very nice survivability options, and it also provides the Spirit Ward skill, which we have down here. And I really think that this item fits very well visually to this item. This is the item. And this is the other item. Oops, I'm nude. Now, here we have Apollo's Wheel. One copy of the Apollo's Wheel. And here we have a different copy of the Apollo's wheel. I'm using this one because it provides lots of survivability, but also it buffs up piercing damage. This build uses a spear with pierced damage, so here we can see that we have plus 307% pierced damage buff from items and skills to this character, which is a very nice amount. And here we have the Outrider's Buckler. I'm using this one because it has the resisted prefix, which provides two resistances, the fire resistance and the cold resistance. And I also enchanted this one with the Rigid Carapace because this one provides now with the completed charm bonus 81% pierce resist. And I have it maxed out. And of course the item, as we saw before, the Anubis Wrath with attack damage convert to health and attack speed bonus. And the Eternal Embers Relic, which provides attack speed, and the bonus 50% chance of 120 piercing damage. So this is the build. I will take this build throughout the whole legendary difficulty and we will see how well it will play out. The resistance is when I have all skills activated, we have 72% fire, 31 cold, 51 lightning, perfect pierce, 30 vitality, perfect poison, 33 bleeding, 32 physical resistance, which is awesome to have on top of this one. Which means that now it is super hard for enemies to kill me by using physical damage, because I have great armor combinations. And also I have added physical resistance from this, you know, from items, whatever. This is my attack speed, which is great. The average damage. Of course, these numbers, average damage and DPS go up when I hit with rune weapon, because this one increases total damage, elemental damage, intelligence. And yeah, this is the starting point, you could say. Here we don't have great resistances, but we have some crucial ones. Stun and trap are very, very important, and slow as well. These are the most important ones back here. Of course, the disruption as well would be great, but anyway, I don't have it. Movement speed is perfect. I don't have casting speed, but anyway. Defensive ability is very good. Offensive needs fixing, but I will fix it by spending more skill points to this one, Rune Ward Feather. And overall, this build is good. So, let's go kill something to show you some gameplay. $3,000, $5,000. It is going up because of rune weapon skill. First we attack with rune weapon. Actually we attack all the time with rune weapon here. And sometimes we use the other two skills down here, this one and this one. This build has two movement speed skills. It has this one, the Thunder Strike, and the Take Down. Of course, turtles may have great pierce resistances, this is why with the spear you will not deal so much damage on them, to them. Now we have this ambient music here, which is horror based, you could say. Legendary already? Nice. Call me Freddy. That was a spellbreaker. He spell broke my skills. But I defeated and I killed all dead people here. Nice. Should I go that way first? So if turtles have great pierce resistance and we don't deal so much damage with that attack, then we can use the thunder strike, and with this one we will deal even more damage to them. Nothing there. So as we can see, this build doesn't have many different skills to use during combat. And it is very simple to play. Take down. Freezing of Devouring. Now we can see how the attack damage compared to health works. When we attack enemies that we can life leech actually, because for example we cannot life leech undead enemies. Attack damage converted to health is life leech, but it is instant life leech. It is not the same as life leech over time. So yeah, we don't have perfect resistances, but we can compensate to that with the attack damage compared to health. So guys, this is the gameplay of this build. Very straightforward, very easy, very few skills to use for people that prefer using very few skills. This one is very good. It is also very interesting to me as a build because it uses many green items, mastery frequents, that I haven't used many times in endgame builds. So, I will take this build throughout the whole legendary difficulty and we will see how good it will be in the end. But for a build which tries to be a little bit experimental maybe, or maybe not so much, this is a very interesting build. So this is it for the first video of 2024. If you have any questions, leave a comment below, hit the like button if you like what you see, subscribe to stay tuned with more content, and remember that in the future, who knows when, Titan Quest 2 is coming, and this channel here will cover that game as much as humanly possible, if the game will be good. So, have a great one, I'll see you very soon again. Subscribe!